If you're serious about building a real online coaching, consulting, and or course business, there are certain systems and things that you need to have in place in your business so that you have a real business, right? One that has predictable and consistent traffic, sales, revenue, recurring revenue. And it's not something where you have to hustle every day to get your next sale or post on social media to get your next client, right? And so that's what we're going to talk about today. We're going to talk about what I like to call the three layers of certainty that you need to build into your business to make sure that you have a real business from day one that's gonna stand the test of time, that's going to continue consistently making sales into the foreseeable future, and that doesn't rely on you having to show up and hustle 24 hours a day to make sales. So let's talk about what those three layers are. The first layer is the income layer. So this is probably a duh, no-brainer, because without revenue in your business, you do not have a business. And so this first layer that you want to be building in consists of a few things. First, it's making sure that you've got the basics covered, that you have a market, right? That you know the audience, the ideal client avatar, common terms, whatever you want to call it, so that you have an audience that wants what you have to sell. It's also making sure that you've got a product, whether that's a coaching offer, a consulting offer, an online program, a course, whatever that looks like, wherever you're starting out. Although, if you've followed me and my content for any amount of time, you know I pretty much, for this type of business, always recommend starting out with an online coaching offer. I mean, the coaching offer itself does not have to be online. You can do it through calls and such, but a coaching offer. And making sure that it's something that people want, and then doing the activities that you need to do to actually get sales. That's what it comes down to. And that's really all you need to be focused on to really create that income layer where you know you have a product, it has a market fit that generates income. Now, there's a lot that goes into doing that. I have a ton of videos on my channel that walk you in depth through all of those different areas. There's not one specific one because it's a lot of things. So if you are interested, you're gonna have to check out my YouTube channel and look at the wealth of information that I have there. And so that's the income layer. And in that first layer, all you're focused on is starting to generate income. And I want you to notice, at this point, you're not worried about trying to build any other layers. You're not trying to worry about building a funnel or long-term traffic or a beautiful system. That's gonna come down the road, and we're gonna talk about that in just a bit. Where you wanna start out is making sure that, hey, I've got something that I can make sales of to a market that wants that, and I have made some sales so that I've got proof of concept. In the beginning of your business, that's the only thing that you are focused on, so that anything that you need to do, your list of to-dos, what you first ask yourself is, hey, is this something that's going to help me generate that income certainty? The certainty that I know I've got something that can generate revenue in my business. Without that, nothing else matters. If something that you're wanting to do doesn't directly contribute to that, right? For example, spending a few hours making your website a little prettier or spending a few hours updating your email sequence. If you are new to email marketing and aren't great at copywriting and are just new to your business, that's not a great use of your time. What is a good use of your time is finding potential clients who would be interested in what you have to offer and then sharing your offer with them and seeing where that leads you. Again, I have way more details in my other videos, so if you're serious about building your business, make sure you check those out. So that's the first layer, and I want you to notice that in each layer, we are only focused on a few things at a time, and this is really key because The truth is, there is a lot to building an online business, right? Or really any sort of business. An online business of coaching, consulting, and or courses is actually simpler than a ton of other businesses. And that's great news if that's the kind of business that you're building. However, there's still a lot to do. And so in each layer, you want to be focused on just a few things that are going to really consolidate that layer. So if you think about the three layers of certainty I'm walking you through right now, you can think about it as like a cake, right? One sheet, one layer at a time. You don't start on the next layer without the foundation, the layers underneath it first. So that first one is the income, making sure you've got revenue in your business. Before that, nothing else matters. Now, the second layer is what I like to call proof certainty. And this is certainty that what the product that you are selling, whether that's coaching, consulting, courses, whatever that looks like, is something that is helping your clients get results. And this is really key because even if you are amazing at marketing, sales, everything under the sun, but you have a bad product, sooner or later, word is going to get out that it is not something that is worth your client's investment. And when that happens, guess what? You're going to be sunk in the water. Whereas even if you are new to your industry, no matter how saturated you think that industry is, no matter how big the players in your industry are, if you are starting to work with clients and you're getting a testimonial or two, that's going to instantly help you stand out and say, hey, look, I know what I'm talking about. I've helped so-and-so get these results. And that's proof that I know what I'm talking about and I can help you as well. So that is really key. And so what I usually recommend is after getting your first few clients, and I mean, this is something you want to do for the entire length of your business, basically, but especially in the beginning, to be spending as much of your time and energy as possible helping those clients get the best results possible. You want to be over delivering the heck out of whatever it is you sold so that your clients come back and say, wow, this was awesome. Here are my results. And yes, I'm happy to give you a testimonial, right? Because that's really the most important thing in the beginning. And once you have those one or two testimonials, what happens? First of all, you have confidence that what you're selling is something that is of value to your audience. And I cannot underscore enough how important that is for your own mental confidence and for you to be able to continue going out there and marketing and talking about your content, your services, your offers, all of that. At this point, we've worked with thousands of students and clients, and I will tell you, when that shift starts happening, things start taking off because you feel that internal confidence. Hey, I know my stuff, and I knew before I had my first client, I knew my stuff, but now I know my stuff. Actually, I've seen the results that it does help other people get results, right? And so that's really key. What that also does is it starts adding credibility to you instantly. You can say, hey, I've done this myself, right? I've spent decades, years, however much, gaining this knowledge, experience myself. I've gone through these. I've gotten these results for myself. And guess what? It's not just me. I've helped so-and-so get these results as well. So that is super key. So that's proof certainty. Once you know, hey, I've got income, I've got proof this is going to work, then you know, all right, I've got the foundational layers and I am in business. Which then prepares you for the third layer. And that layer is what I like to call growth certainty. So the way I like to think about building an online business and the way I teach it as well is to think about it as like gathering data and learning, right? And what happens when you're doing that? You start out, you know, let's assume, because no one is born knowing marketing or sales knowledge, right? You start out, you know what it is you're going to coach on, but you don't know anything about marketing, sales, copywriting. I mean, this is where I started when I started my first online business. And all you've got is your knowledge and that desire to help others, right? And so you get that first client. What happens through getting that first client and starting to build that income certainty? Well, you learn a little bit about, first, I know who my client is. I know what it is that drove them to me specifically, right? Was it something I said? Was it something in my background? What about what was going on with them personally made that moment the right time for them to be ready and willing to invest with me? You know all of those things. Basically, you're gathering marketing data. That first client is essentially paying you, and of course they're getting your coaching and the result that they want, but they're also basically paying you and giving you data at the same time, paying you to learn about how to coach and market and sell. And then once you have that, you also, through working with your first few clients, and usually what I see is after about three clients, you've really established a pattern. You have a system for delivering that coaching, that course, whatever it is, your methodology as well. So you know, hey, on the first call for every single client, this is what we talk about. On the second call, these are the questions that come up. And so you're starting to see a pattern and you've got a system for how to deliver it. Once you've gathered that data through the first two layers, right? Having that income certainty, having that proof certainty, then you've got all the pieces that you need to really grow and to scale. So I interchangeably use call the third layer either growth certainty or scaling certainty. It's the same principle where now you're ready to build a system, right? You're able to say, okay, I now can create an email sequence where I address all of the things that I know are the reasons that people come to me. And as I get more and more clients, I can handle them because now I have a system, right? I can turn it into a group program. I can turn it into a course. Whatever that leveraged version looks like for you. For the majority of my students and clients, that first leveraged version is a group program where you no longer offer one-on-one calls like you do in one-on-one coaching. But instead, you offer a group call every week, every 2 weeks, whatever that looks like. You offer some sort of support, forum or group, Facebook group, Slack, whatever that looks like. And then when you have that, that's your system. You've got the content up front that when someone finds you, drives them to be ready to buy from you. You've got your sales process, whether that's a sales call, a sequence of emails to a sales page, depending on what you're selling. And then you've got the delivery method that you've systematized from working with those clients in the first two layers. And that prepares you to grow because then you can focus on, all right, what do I need to do to get the word out there, right? Do I go on there are a few options. Do I focus on creating a ton of content on a certain channel, on YouTube, social media, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, whatever the best channel is for my industry and where my clients are? Or another option is, okay, do I start investing in paid advertising? Because now I know how to monetize my traffic, so I'm not just throwing money down the drain. I'm able to start testing, okay, for every $1 that comes in, this is how much I'm making, right? And I know the exact audience I need to speak to, so I know how to find them and target them using paid traffic. So that's really key as well. And then the question becomes, okay, I know the source, right? Is it going to be some sort of affiliate source, organic traffic, paid traffic, whatever that looks like? And then, okay, what is that sales, marketing, conversion methodology going to be? Is it going to be a quote unquote evergreen funnel where I have this content that I've built, I share it with them, and then they are driven to the sales process, the process that I just outlined for you a few seconds ago? Or am I going to do a launch, an upfront launch to really build momentum, to really kind of plant my flag in my industry, right? And say, hey, I'm here. Take notice, because I've got a great system. I've got that proof that I am able to help my clients get results. And now I'm ready to launch with a small program. And what that does is it allows you to build a lot of momentum quickly where, let's say you go the program route, right? Then you're able to sell your program at a lower price point than your coaching, which helps you attract a different audience of people who maybe really wanted to work with you, but they weren't ready to invest in your coaching yet. You are ready to do that. You're able to make a few more sales than from your one-on-one coaching. You're able to get your name out there more, to get more clients, to get more testimonials, right? And then here's the beauty of it. Once you've done that, at the end of your course or program, you can say to those people, hey, Did you love the results? Did you really enjoy your experience working with me through this small course? And if you've done a good job, which you will, a lot of people are going to say yes. And how can I continue working with you more to get more and bigger results? And that's when you can say, hey, at this point, now that we've built a lot more trust, you've seen the results, if you'd like to continue working with me in my private coaching program or whatever your next program is, here's how we can do that. And this can double or triple your initial upfront launch revenue, right? So I'm just sharing two of the most common options of what I help my clients through in layer three of the growth or scale certainty layer. And when that happens, I want you to notice each point, each layer, we're systematizing certain things, right? Even if you aren't like overthinking it, or you might not even realize it as you're doing it, because that's the beauty of this. You create the systems as you go versus sitting in a cave or a vacuum trying to theorize all of it and then implementing it and failing, right? You're building revenue and results as you go along. And so after that initial first launch or funnel and traffic source, what you've got is you've got a scaling or growth strategy that works. Then what we look at is, okay, this is something that's scalable. What's next? Do we have you continue spending more on paid ads because now we know this scales? Do we have you bump up your content creation because we are seeing this have really great returns for you and so we want to draw more people to you faster? Do we want to plan your next launch that's going to be bigger now that you know the strategies and numbers and your conversion rates and everything? But once you have that, guess what you have? You've got a predictable system for consistently growing and scaling your income. And the strategy that we end up choosing is based on your personal preferences, your personal lifestyle choices, your business goals, all of that. That's why I share two of the most common ones. And you can think through, all right, you know, based on my personal preferences and goals, which one of these might be a better fit? And what's going to happen is as you work through layers one and two, that's going to give you an idea for where you want to go in layer three as well. But notice what you have is you've built in a consistent set of systems, layers in your business so that you've got the income, you've got the proof, and then you've got the consistent growth and scale. So what you end up building is a real business that continues to grow instead of something where you get a sale here or there. You have a good month and then you have no idea where your next sale is coming from. That's not a real or a good business. It's just really another really stressful job, right? And who wants that? So those are the three layers of certainty that you absolutely want to be building your business. And I really want you to take lots of notes and really think through when each layer happens, as I shared, right? We're not starting on the growth or scale layer on day one. And the reason for that is if you did that without the data and the results that you're going to get from the first two layers, you're setting yourself up for a lot of stress and most likely failure. All right. So that's what I've got for you today. I've got two other things for you if you found this helpful. The first thing I've got is another really great video tutorial on how to qualify your coaching clients and make sure that you're not just attracting some randos who aren't going to respect you or your time or your investment, but who actually are dream clients and who love paying you, love working with you, love doing the work to get the results and end up helping you get more and more testimonials and work with the best clients possible. So make sure you check out that video. It's either going to be somewhere on the screen and or linked in the description below. And I've also got a really great PDF for you on the map for the blueprint for how to build a six-figure coaching business, right? That's going to replace your job income. That's going to allow you to do it before you leave your job so that you're not leaving your job, burning the boats and wondering, can I really make this work? Am I going to have to go back to a job? So again, that is either going to be somewhere on the screen and or linked in the description below. So make sure you check that out. That's all I've got for you today. If you are new to my channel, go ahead and hit subscribe to be notified every week when I release a brand new video on building your own online coaching and or course business. And leave me a comment about your biggest takeaway. I try and respond as many comments as possible. And so I'd love to hear from you. And thanks so much for being here. I will see you next time.